Welcome to Eleni Fragrance, ladies and gents. So in this video, we'll be doing a buying guide in the Versace Eros line, which started back in 2012 with the original Eau de Toilette. All right, so the newer bottles, they say Eau de Toilette on the bottle underneath Versace Eros, but the older ones, they just say Versace Eros. So if you see one that says Versace Eros like this by itself, this is the Eau de Toilette, guys. All right, so I absolutely love this scent DNA. It is a mass pleaser. You give any of these fragrances to literally just anyone to smell and they will absolutely love it, guys. Very easy to wear, scent, versatile. I'd argue that it's an all season type of fragrance, but I mean, to my nose, because of the gourmandy facets that it does have, I would rather wear any of the Versace Eros, you know, the original and the flankers, spring, fall, and winter, not summer. Summer, I'd rather wear something like Versace Pour Homme or Chanel Allure, Homme Sport or Extreme, Missoni Wave. I'd rather wear those. So Versace Eros in the fragrance community, it's considered a clubbing scent, along with Jean Paul Gaultier's Ultra Male, 1 Million by Paco Rabanne, and Carolina Herrera 212 or 112, something like you'll see the picture right here. This is the Carolina Herrera that a lot of guys use in you know, clubbing events and whatnot. So yeah, you know, we'll smell all of them and I will let you guys know what I think, you know, which ones are best. Don't get the whole collection. I have it because I'm a collector, so I'll let you guys know the best ones to get out of this line. So before we get started, make sure you use promo code LNEFRAG10 for an additional 10% off in the Perfume Love Store website. So make sure to use it. You'll get an additional 10% on the already discounted price. All right, so with all that being said, let's get this show started, guys. All right, so I already know how all of these fragrances smell. So this will not be a first impression type of video, but I will still spray them in the tester strip to see, to kind of remind me how I feel about it and talk about it with you guys. So Versace Eros, it's also known for being very minty, green apple forward. It is sweet with some aromatic facets to it. Kind of airy, very clean, smooth, ozonic, very easy to love type of fragrance. You know, Eros is the god of love, I believe, in Greek mythology. So, you know, it's supposed to be used to attract the opposite sex, guys. You know, which is why guys use it for clubbing events, you know. All right, so let's check out the original Eau de Toilette. I love this stuff, guys. I mean, this stuff is just so good. So what you get out of this, it's like this juicy green apple with a very fresh mint. Like when you freshly cut the mint leaves, that smell that gives, like that, just very fresh mint, juicy green apple. I believe this has some white florals to give the fragrance, this formulation, some balance to it. And creamy, smooth woods in the far end, like in the far background. So, you know, in the front of the scent, like what you get at first when you first smell, is that green apple with the fresh cut mint. Yeah, I absolutely love this, guy. So I'd say the demographic, it's like between 17 years old and 25. So if you're between 17 and 25, this is perfect for you guys. All right. So Versace Eros Eau de Toilette, I give it an 8.5 out of 10, guys. So here we have the Eau de Parfum. And then, yeah, let's smell it. So the Eau de Parfum, it's equally as seductive, alluring, welcoming as the Eau de Toilette, but it's richer, it's denser, deeper. And it's also creamier. The green apple comes across a tad creamier, like if it has some whipped cream in it. It has a balanced level of sweetness. It's not overly sweet. And I can tell this one doesn't project as much as the original Eau de Toilette does. I'll give it like maybe 1 to 2 feet projection. But the Eau de Toilette, I'd say like 3 to 4 feet. Yeah, this one projects like a beast. Yeah, so the Eau de Parfum is a bit more mature. So picture this, all right? So the Eau de Toilette, it's the guy in the club that he wants to dance with the ladies, have a few drinks, you know, be very like a party animal per se. But the Eau de Parfum comes across as the guy that's by the bar. Maybe he's just chilling there with his friends, talking about business, having a few martinis or vodka, whatever he's drinking, I don't know. And yeah, like that's how I see it. So that being said, the demographic of the Eau de Parfum, it's 25 to 35, even pushing 40, I'd say. Yeah, like 25 to 40, the Eau de Parfum. All right, and then I give that one a 9 out of 10, guys. So we have here the Parfum, which was released recently last year. Actually, a lot of people didn't know about the Parfum. This one, Versace, I don't know, Versace just decided to, hey, here's Versace Eros Parfum. We're not going to announce it. There's no commercials, no ads, but here it is. Go to Dillard's, buy it. That's pretty much what Versace did with the Parfum version, you know, from the Eros line. But yeah, let's smell it. So the parfum has, it's sort of a polarizing scent in the community because they did away with the green apple and I believe the mint as well, I'm not sure. I looked up the notes for all of these, but I just can't remember right now. But what I do know is that they included Italian lemon or lemon zest. It has a lemon note, guys. And that's sort of, you know, something that they did that the community just didn't like it, like about it. But it smells great. I absolutely love it. This is the densest one out of the line. It has a powdery nuance to it. It sits closer to the skin, so I would say it has like a 1 foot projection. Yeah, it's still great, guys. I mean, I love the whole entire line, regardless of what people are saying in the community about the Eros Parfum. And that one I give a 9 out of 10 as well. Since it comes across a tad more mature, I'd say that Eros Parfum, it's perfect for guys that are, I'd say, 35 plus. Yeah, 35 plus, the Eros Parfum. And then we have here Eros Flame. This is the only one that's red with a golden cap, and it's an eau de parfum. So yeah, this is like the one that wants to be different out of the whole group, since, you know, the other Versace Eros bottles are turquoise. This is the only red one. But yeah, let's try it out here. So Versace Eros Flame, it's actually my second favorite out of the line. My first favorite, it's the Eau de Parfum, and then the Eros Flame is my second favorite. I love the spicy nuance associated with this fragrance. I believe it has like a pepper note, or not sure if it's pink pepper or Achiato or Chiato, I think that's what they call it. But it definitely has a spice which sets it apart from the Eros DNA. It does have, So it does have the Eros DNA, but it just has these juxtaposed nuances associated with it that sort of makes it go a little bit of a different direction. But when you smell it up close, you can tell, yeah, this belongs in the Eros line. So yeah, this fragrance, I give it a 9.5 out of 10, guys. And then also, like I said, the Eros Parfum, I believe I gave it a 9. I guess I could give it a 9.5 as well, just like the Eros Flame, because to me they're tied. You know, I love the whole entire line, guys. I recommend it. So the two that I recommend for you to get in your collection are the following. All right, if you're a young guy, get the Eau de Toilette. But if you are 25 plus, the two that you need in your collection It's the Eau de Parfum and the Flame. And I say the Flame because this one introduces new notes in it that makes it go a little bit of a different direction, but it keeps the Eros DNA intact with a few spicy notes in it. So get the Eau de Parfum or the Flame or both, you know. All right, guys, so that's my take on the Versace Eros line. And then, as always, stay fresh. Peace out.